and thank you for spending your evening with us to celebrate Black History Month. We are so glad that you are here.
The restrooms are located out the back doors down the long hallway on your right. Or to the atrium, please put your phones on silent. Thank you and enjoy the show.
We'll have a word of prayer to start with. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this evening and thank you for allowing our guests to come. We are so thankful that we have this opportunity on today. Please bless the students and their efforts, oh God, as they prepare to give a word about Black history. We are so thankful. Amen.
Amen.
Lift every voice and sing. But first, let's learn a little bit about the song. John Weldon Douglas wrote this: that lift every waist and sing. The national anthem for millions of Black Americans. Johnson was known as a man of many talents, most of which he used to shape America's history. Lift Every Voice and Sing was one of Johnson's most famous poems. The poem was later taken to music by John Chrisman Douglas. That's right, James and John are brothers.
John Roslyn Johnson was an American composer and singer during the Harlem Renaissance. He was born in Jacksonville, Florida in 1873. While he's chiefly remembered today as the composer of the Black National Anthem, Lift Every Voice and Sing, he had a varied career as a pianist, songwriter, producer, singer, soldier, and actor. Over his lifetime, Johnson arranged more than 150 spirituals and over 160 musical theater numbers.
Thank you. sponsor for our school's Black Student Union, and I'm joined by our club president, Victoria Dotson. We'd like to take a couple of minutes up front to talk about a couple of Black luminaries who passed away and discuss a couple of the watershed moments that we've lived through over this past year. I'd like to begin by talking a bit about Colin Powell. Powell began his military career, culminating in his achievement of the rank of four-star general. He was appointed to the chairman position of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. His sense of honor and duty were such that he made friends on both sides of the political aisle, leading many to believe that had he chosen to run for president in 1996 against then-incumbent President Clinton, that he very well could have become the first Black president of the United States. Powell chose a different path, though, and his political career reached its pinnacle when he was appointed as the first Black Secretary of State. His tenure in that role was not without controversy, but Powell weathered that controversy with his sense of honesty, his sense of cooperation, his ability to reach across the political divide. At a time where the divisions in this country are as deep as they've ever been, his sense of unflappable integrity will be sorely missed.
Sidney Poitier, actor, scholar, first Black man. Sidney Poitier, born February 20th, 1927, was the first Black male to win an Academy Award for Best Male Actor. He is one of the only four Black men now to have won an Oscar. Some of his notable films are Lilies of the Field, Guess Who's Coming to Dinner, and Heat of the Night. We have a short film from Heat of the Night that is noted. More about Sidney Poitier. In 2009, former President Obama awarded him the Medal of Freedom to recognize him, and then he passed away recently on January 6th, 2020 of Alzheimer's. And just like Colin Powell, we will remember him right now. The point of the film, In Heat of the Night, what is significant is that he said that he wouldn't do the film at all. There was a part where his character like slapped him across the face, and he said that he wouldn't do the film at all if he didn't get his stuff back. And that's one of the first times Black actors can have a voice into the film that they're in. As of last year, 21 officers were convicted of either manslaughter or murder, which is the highest number in American history. Derek Chauvin was arrested and sentenced to 22 years of prison for the murder of George Floyd. Kim Potter was sentenced to 2 years of prison for the murder of Dante Wright. And Eric Delvenier has not been sentenced yet for the murder of Cameron Lamb, and he is also the first Kansas City officer to be convicted of murder. After 200 years, there has been progress and officers are being held accountable for their actions, but we still need progress. In 2014, Michael Brown, a 15-year-old, was shot and killed by an officer named Darren Wilson in Ferguson, Missouri, and he is living life like a normal man, never convicted, and is protected by official holiday. It is meant to celebrate the freedom of slaves and the
end of the Civil War. Union troops went to Texas, Galveston, and notified any last remaining slaves for their freedom. Oakley, or the grandma of Juneteenth, fought for years for Juneteenth to become an official holiday, and she pledged to walk 1,400 miles from her home from Texas to Washington to make sure it became a holiday, and was invited last year to the White House to see the signing of Biden. There's various different ways that we celebrate Juneteenth, like cookouts, traditional black cookouts and parties, and supporting black businesses, and beauty pageants, all sorts. The only state now that doesn't recognize Juneteenth as a holiday is North Dakota.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, now we will enjoy Jace Ketchum playing on his guitar, Chair Rock by Smashing Pumpkins. Now we would have had some video and things playing, so I need you to just give these next few people your undivided attention and cheer them on. And we will have Angel Wilson singing the legendary song by Bill Withers, Lean On Me. Thank you.
Yeah. feel the night. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer, gonna keep on keeping on. I can feel it. I'm gonna fight with the strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer, gonna keep on keeping on.
All of that. While he might not be known as a computer guru Jobs, and Bill Gates. Dr. Mark Dean's contributions to the personal computer aren't any less notable. He holds some of the largest, most groundbreaking personal computer patents, including the first color PC monitor, the first gigahertz chip, which is a revolutionary piece of technology that's able to do a billion calculations per second. He also co-invented this industry standard architecture system bus, which means computers can plug in like disk drives and printers. Dr. Mark Dean earned his master's degree in electrical engineering from Florida Atlantic University in 1982, and then 10 years later, he completed his doctorate in the same field from Stanford University. He has taught computer science at Harvard University and is currently the John Fisher Distinguished Professor at the University of Tennessee. Dean has said, a lot of kids growing up today aren't told that you can be whatever you want to be. There may be obstacles, but there are no limits. Meet Mrs. Henrietta Lacks. On January 29, 1951, Mrs. Lacks went to Johns Hopkins Hospital to diagnose abnormal pain and bleeding in her abdomen. Physician Dr. Howard Jones quickly diagnosed her with cervical cancer. During her subsequent radiation treatments, doctors removed two cervical samples from Mrs. Lacks without her knowledge. She died at Johns Hopkins on October 4, 1951, at the age of 31. Now, Mrs. Lacks' cells were unlike any of the others Dr. Jones had ever seen. Where other cells would die, Mrs. Lacks' cells doubled every 20 to 24 hours. Today, these incredible cells, nicknamed HeLa, from the first two letters of her first and last names, they are used to study the effects of toxins, drugs, hormones, and viruses on the growth of cancer cells without experimentation on humans. They've been used to test the effects of radiation and poisons, to study the human genome, to learn more about how viruses work, and they've played a crucial role in the development of both the polio and COVID-19 vaccines. In 1998, when the BBC screened an award-winning documentary on Lacks and HeLa cells, her story was finally known. Rebecca Sloot later wrote a popular book on her subject called The Immortal Life of Henrietta Lacks. Black women, like Mrs. Lacks, are more likely to have a late-stage diagnosis of the disease and are almost 1.5 times more likely to die of cervical cancer than white women, according to a joint report by the Southern Rural Black Women's Initiative for Economic and Social Justice and the Human Rights Watch. For many women, cervical cancer, while scary, is largely preventable, and if caught early, has a 5-year survival rate of over 90%. Now, statistics are for the next person we're coming up on. In 2017, Imelda B. Rivers was named by Forbes magazine as one of 25 women leading data and analytics in the U.S. government. She graduated top of her class in mathematics from South Carolina State University, and she has her master's degree of science from the University of Maryland, College Park. She's the Director of Human Resources Statistics Program, HRS, of the National Science Foundation's National Center for Science and Engineering Statistics. As the HRS Director, she is responsible for the collection and dissemination of comprehensive information on the education and employment of scientists and engineers. She is the first African-American and first woman to be in charge of the National Science Foundation. Let's listen to Ms. Rivers describe, in her own words, how she is Black history.
Black history. To appreciate the hard sacrificial work put in by those old and young, our ancestors, and even those, some of those sitting in this room today. Major civil rights movement leaders and lawmakers who have worked hand in hand to claw our way to where we are today. To acknowledge that there is still work to be done to correct issues within the Black community, and to celebrate the progress that we have made, the movement has made, America has made, and humanity as a whole have made. We come together to learn about the steps that were put in, the sacrifices fought made, and the literal wars fought. But even with all that,
we're still missing something.
Something that is the major thing. Black future. The scope of the future for the Black community. Where we are headed to go. The optimistic hope for the outcome of the fight that has been fought and is still being fought. Black future is no longer that of tirelessness and pessimism. Black future is that of change, hope, and our favorite word, equality. But not just basic old equality. I'm talking about when we're done being late to history. When we're done being 232 years late to having representation in the White House. When we are done being 244 years late to having representation in the Vice President's residence. When we're done having to hear that the first Black woman to serve on the Supreme Court will be announced soon, as in not yet. When we no longer have presidential candidates berated for supporting segregationists. When we are done having to create our own network to have representation on television. When Black men are no longer unproportionately targeted by the police. When justice is no longer so rare that we have to celebrate every single time we achieve it. When policing is no longer a danger to some communities and a savior to others. When we no longer have to chant, no justice, no peace, through the streets of every single United States, state, and territory. Black future is when affirmative action is no longer needed. When large corporations stop deeming minority neighborhoods as a place to dump their waste. When there are no more firsts before a Black person's name and job title. When there is no longer a shock when a Black person has made it in their career or receives a certain award. When we no longer have to go before the Supreme Court about our hair. When young Black men no longer feel bombarded by the attack coming from them at each angle. When young Black women no longer feel the double whammy of being a person of color and female. When Black people no longer have to worry about becoming a part of one of those statistics. When you think about Black history, you will think about how America is a story told over a long horizon, punctuated by times by hardship, but ultimately written by generations of citizens who have somehow worked together, without fanfare, to create a more perfect union. Black future is when, much like you've seen in this program today, race is no longer a determining factor. Culture and ethnicity can be appreciated, acknowledged, and celebrated by all. It is when the NAACP's job is complete, when we can celebrate Black history as just that, history, not current events that we still have to acknowledge and fight against today. When, hypothetically speaking, a high schooler doesn't have to get in front of a crowd of other high schoolers and their family members and discuss Black future. And when those famous words of Dr. Martin Luther King become moral law, that we will one day live in a nation where we will not be judged by the color of our skin, but by the content of our character.
Thank you.
territory. I want to thank all of you for coming tonight. We also have our Black Student Union. We have our president and our vice president from last year. Y'all want to come up here? Aaliyah Reed and Kayla Marshall. And our president for this year is Victoria Dotson. Can you come up, Victoria? Madison Marshall. Madison Marshall's assistants. I don't know what they had. And then, and all those out there who are members of the Black Student Union, can you all stand up? All right, now you can see their faces. And I want to thank all of our William Chrisman High School teachers that came out here today to support us. Let's give them a hand. Too. So thank him for coming. We also want to thank our principal, Mr. Becker. We want to thank all of our custodial staff, everybody who helped us to do this program. Mr. Smithson is also our Black Student Union sponsor. Mr. Hopkey comes through with our live streaming. Yes, thank you. And my hubby's in the audience too.
Let's go!